Take that thing out of here and take that down to stateroom 76-7. Give me a good table in the dining room. Reserve a seat at the ship's concert. Place a $2 bet in the ship's pool. Find me a young fellow named Billy Crocker. He's got my passport.
Oh, will you step this way, Mr. Whitney? We'd like to have a picture of you. Elijah J. Whitney. You know, Wall Street.
Okay, we're through with you, Mr. Whitney. Who's next, Charlie? No time to waste.
A concert? Sir Oakland. You and Miss Harper, right? That way, too. Society stuff.
What are their names?
Sir, what is your first
name? My name is Ethan.
Not her first name, your first name.
I repeat, it is Ethan.
My fiance, Miss Hill Harper.
Get a good rubber shot. They're selling to be married on the other side.
Look, you can't marry both of you. Which one is the bride?
So, well, this is Mrs. Hawthorne.
Please, feel free to call me mother.
Oh, righto, mother.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Harcourt, but we'd like to have a picture of the happy couple.
Say miss. Look happy. Say cheese.
Hey, Edith, put your arm around her.
Oh, I'm afraid that this is the best that we can do.
Okay, do you mind moving to one side? Who are they?
Oh, a missionary and a couple of Christians.
No one's gonna print that stuff. Give me a gal.
Hey, girlies,
how would you like if your picture's taken in the paper? Get in there and do your stuff, kids.
Hey, Bishop, give me a little dope on yourself.
The name is Henry T. Dawson, D.C., Ph.D., LL.D., and moderator of the Chinese Anglican Church. Honorary chaplain of the Army of the Chinese Republic. Author, lecturer, and president of the Westminster Council.
A swell story for a Chinese edition.
Well, how about my photo? Yeah, I guess we want one of you coming up the gangplank.
There for a drink.
Say goodbye, girls.
Goodbye.
meeting you. If I'm not in the chapel, I'll be in the bar.
Boss, what a trip you're gonna have. The most beautiful girls in the world and you right in the middle of them. Now, am I the greatest general manager or am I not?
You're not. You're fired.
What, again?
Yes, again. You can consider those 2 weeks in Washington your final notice. You're fired in the sense of being through, finished, kaput, washed up, done, terminated.
Through!
What was that all about?
That was me being fired.
Great! And you're coming to London with me!
Oh, that's the best offer I've had since I've been unemployed.
Well, how long will it take you to pack?
Oh, that's my other shirt.
Well, Billy, you'll be great. You can sing, you can dance. Billy, you're my new master of ceremonies.
Oh, no, Reno, I don't think so.
Why not? I think you'd be marvelous.
But you're the one with all the talent.
Tell me more.
Well, you're beautiful, you're smart, and sexy.
True. Tell me more.
Well, I'm running out of words to do you justice. At words, boy, I'm so pathetic that I always have found it best, instead of getting them off my chest, to let them rest unexpressed. I hate parading my serenade, as I'll probably miss a bar. So if this ditty is not so pretty, at least it'll tell you how great you are. You're the top, you're the Colosseum.
Perfect, I won't fail.
You're an old Dutch master, you're late.
papers.
Oh, that's all right, boss. I'll take care
of it. You're hired again. What would I do without you?
Well, you just go and have a good time, okay? Oh, Reno, I want you to make sure Mr. Whitney has a good time.
Oh, don't worry, Billy. I have four fallen angels holding up the bar. Come, let us lead them beside the distilled waters.
Well, where have you been for these last 3 months? I've been going crazy trying to find you ever since that night.
Billy, there's something that I must explain to you.
Oh, dear.
Oh, dear. A major strike. Holy up.
Oh, Evelyn, dear, I'd like you to meet Billy Crocker.
Ah, put it there, Crocker, old chap.
Sir Evelyn Oakley, my fiancé. We're sailing to be married in London.
Your fiancé?
Yes.
And you're sailing to be married?
Yes.
Then I'm sailing too.
Then we'll be meeting again?
Again and again and again.
Somebody else.
What did you do?
Oh,
there he is. She's that man. Come on, I'm going to take sure not to sit on this ship.
What is this? I protest! I'm Bishop Henry P. Dawson! Help!
Tell it to the FBI. Juan Voyage!
Well, how soon do we get there?
Oh, you'll know when we do. Uh-oh, feel that? I think it's starting.
Oh, Lord, I think I shall no doubt prepare myself for death. And you hope.
I think I'll...
It's getting worse. Uh-oh, there it goes.
Lord, there I go.
Was that fair?
Fair? I find you standing here in the moonlight with him? I didn't shoot him. I didn't push him overboard. I think that was very fair.
Look, Billy, you've got to stop this. We met one night, one single night, at a party. Well, we danced, and we had a little too much to drink, and then we took a little spin around the park.
Little spin? You call 12 hours in the back of a taxi a little spin?
9 hours.
12. 9 with you and 3 before I could borrow enough money to pay off the thug that was driving.
Oh, and I spent 3 hours trying to explain everything to Mother, and you weren't much help.
I was very nice to your mother.
Nice? Telling Mother you were George Bernard Shaw?
Well, I just wanted her to know that you'd be in good hands.
Well, she wasn't amused. Listen, Billy, you'd better stay out of Mother's way for the rest of the trip. She hasn't forgotten or forgiven you for that evening.
I see you've forgotten. What's this nonsense about a fiancé?
It's not nonsense, Billy. I've been engaged to Sir Evelyn for quite some time now. Well, with the exception of 12 hours one night. 9.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, it's off again. And this seagoing hack is a big improvement over the back of a taxi. The moon is doing better by us, too.
Oh, it's getting late, Billy. I better call it a night.
Oh, no, not yet, please. Just 5 minutes. Just a quick spin around the deck.
Oh, I remember the last time you took a quick spin.
Oh, here we are on the deck of a ship in the moonlight. Doesn't that mean anything to you? The night is young. The sky is clear. And if you'd like to go walking, dear, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely. I understand the reason why sentimental has stolen mine. It's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely. You can tell at a glance what a swell night this is for romance. You can hear dear Mother Nature.
Me.
morning.
Where do I put it, sir?
Where do you usually put it?
Well, most of them have breakfast in bed, sir.
They do, huh? Well, I guess that's all right.
But you have got breakfast.
Well, that's even a better idea. I sleep up here. You know, I nearly fell out the last time we were at that court. Thank you.
Oh, what a night it's been. What a dawn. What a sunrise. What the devil are you doing up there?
This is when you have breakfast on a boat. Here, will you take this thing? You going to bed?
I'm never going to bed on this trip. Hey, doctor, you've got to help me out. I need a change of clothes. They're beginning to stare at me up on deck. I need a suit, I need shirts, shoes, ties.
One thing at a time.
Shoes! Yes, can you tell me which cabin Elisha J. Whitney is in? 76M?
Here you go, Doc. The corner was full of...
Doc, we've got to change our cabin.
Boy, I kind of like it here. It's nice and cozy.
My boss is in the next cabin.
You mean the gray-haired guy with short-sighted glasses?
He thinks I'm back running Wall Street. If he ever sees me on this ship, well,
maybe he won't see you. His glasses!
Doc, I don't know what church you belong to, but brother, you're a Christian.
We're men of the cloth and our frivolous moments.
Steward! Steward!
Excuse me, brother, were you calling for a steward?
I thought I made that clear to everyone on this boat.
Well, I sent him down to the corner for something. He'll be back in a minute. Why don't you just wait a minute?
If I don't get up on deck in a minute, it won't do me a bit of good. Motion of the boat. Beginning to get to me.
Seasick, huh? Why don't you take off your glasses?
I'll do nothing of the kind. I'm in no mood for anything cute. I may need you later, but for right now, I'd rather suffer alone.
If you ever need anything at all, anything at all, you just let me know.
What the hell's in this room? A fine fish?
No. A seagull. Go away. Shoot. Go away. And don't come back.
What are you?
And like I said, I'm a minister on all occasions. If you ever need anything, a funeral or anything, you just let me know.
You get the hell out of here. You're making me nervous.
excuse me. I think I got the wrong hat. Did you read the initial in there?
Where the hell are my glasses?
You sure you had them on when you barged in here?
Sir, this is my stateroom.
Then what am I doing here? I'd have been so insulted in my life. Hey, why don't you put on your other pair of glasses?
I don't have another pair.
Good, that's just what I want to know. Oh, he got his glasses.
Hey, great.
Yes, he got another pair.
Great.
Come in.
Good morning, Bonnie.
Hello, Bonnie.
Billy.
Hiya, Bonnie. Excuse me, Doc. I've got to see a man about a new suit.
But did you have a good night?
Oh, not bad at all. I met the cutest sailor. Safe out here in the ocean if I've got a sail
on hand. Who is it?
The purser.
Come in.
Sorry to disturb you, Doctor, but does James still occupy this cabin?
Well, not very often. Is there something wrong?
I think I have to warn you, Doctor. We've received a radiogram from Washington. He's not James Hill. Snake Eyes Johnson, public enemy number one.
You're kidding!
No, they arrested one of his confederates just because he If he does return, would you come up and tell me?
Sure.
the little girl behind the door.
Gee, what if they grab Billy for snake eyes? He had to take the red off.
I can't let that happen. I kind of like the dog.
Besides, if you got the racket going on, he didn't come in at all that soon.
Aw, Moe, you're just an old softie.
Well, here I am. Going way off. All set for the truth.
Hey, listen, mister, I'm afraid we're in a hell of a jam.
Doctor, I'll have to report you to your bishop.
You might as well start with the bishop. I'm not really a clergyman. I'm moon-faced farmer. I'm a crook. I'm wanted in America.
Oh, nonsense, Doctor. What do they want with another crook in America?
You don't realize who Mooney is. Moonface is public enemy number 13.
Don't we have to mention numbers?
Thank you.
Bypass.
There, I knew Moody was under wraps, but I didn't know your face was decorated. raid in U.S. post offices.
Oh, the ship's officers are looking all over for me.
They think I'm Snake Eyes Johnson.
Snake Eyes Johnson?
Yeah, he couldn't make the ship, so the doc gave me his ticket.
Well, maybe I could fix you up with a little, camouflage.
Reno, if you really want to help, there's something else I'd rather you do.
Anything for you, Billy. Say it, and it's done.
Do you think you could get an English accent off my hands? Steam him up, or keep him out of my way.
Who is the guy?
Sir Evelyn Oakley, the guy who thinks he's going to marry my girl.
The only way to hurt that guy is to bump him off.
No, Doc. No rough stuff. Reno, all you have to do is make a plan for him.
All right, Billy, I'll try. But no promises.
Oh, it's downstairs, ma'am. First quarter to the left.
Doctor, there you are. Have you seen this video?
As a matter of fact, I just saw him going into the mizzen mast.
We don't have a mizzen. Oh, and it must have been someone else.
Never mind that, sailor. No one can help me find this man. Aye, aye, sir.
Say, who's he looking for?
He's looking for Bill.
Billy ought to be a big help to him then. Say, do you know that Englishman Billy's talking about?
I recognize him right here before.
Oh, there you are, Doctor.
Oh, in a world.
Are you taking your sabbatical abroad?
That's not my sabbatical, that's Reno Sweeney.
Oh, no, Reno Sweeney. It is your living job.
Reno, Miss Sweeney, I'd like you to meet him.
I'm delighted to know you, Miss Sweeney. I spent an evening at your nightclub once. Quite eventful. As a matter of fact, it's a affair that I proposed to my fiancé.
You mean propositioned?
Oh, yes. Is that what you Americans call it?
Proposition. It's in my nightclub. It's a proposition.
Well, I had quite an evening. Your scene seemed to stir me, set by pulses racing. I turned to Miss Harcourt, and right there I propositioned her. See here, Miss Harcourt, I said. What about us getting married in a year or two?
Reno, I think your idea is money, man.
She'll be delighted to know that I met you. Shall I go invite her?
Please do.
What about us getting together in my cabin, say, 1 o'clock for cocktails?
Oh, lovely.
I'll go and find Miss Harcourt and let her know. She'll be fine.
You were just great. You kept out of Billy's hair for nearly Oh,
never mind, little face. I've got a date with him, haven't I?
But what about his girlfriend? Three's a crowd, you know.
Maybe you could get to his cabin a little bit early. Get him a little temperature.
I don't know. Those Englishmen have high boiling points.
That's true, too.
Then let's bring him.
You get there a little bit early. Wear dresses and slip out of easily.
I'll guard you. Accuse you of carrying the clothes off. Then I'll blackmail him into breaking the engagement.
Oh, get me behind you, Moonface. I kind of like the guy. He's different.
But Rena, you promised
Bill. Oh, God, almost persuaded me to shoot the works. You know, if you weren't a friend of Billy's, I'd unfrock you.
Rena, there's a toy that works for everything.
Guess what?
What?
We didn't find me.
Hey, Billy, I met your beekeeper. I've got a date with him.
Great.
He talks cute. What's he do for a living?
He doesn't work, Reno. He's a gentleman.
Oh, that gentleman stuff sounds bad. But maybe I could cure him of it.
If you could just keep him away from hope until we get to England, and if the doctor beat the purser out of my hair, I've got it made.
You care of me?
We're together, Billy, through thick or thin.
Night or day, right or wrong.
If you're a veteran, Jane, here I am.
Your mail.
That's friendship.
Friendship. Right.
Simon. Make it snappy. Yes, yes, make it snappy.
Yes, sir.
Come in. Just put it down on the bed. I do hope it's good and hot. You know, I so washed it before I started to dress.
Say, am I early or late?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm so glad that it's you.
Well, I'm certainly glad you feel that way about it. Because I certainly feel that way about you.
What way?
That way.
You know, I love the expression you Americans use. I'm making a collection of them. To feel that way about a person means to rub his neck. Do tell me some others.
Hey, wait a minute. You don't get the idea. I mean, you send me.
I send things to you.
See this? Now I guess you realize how serious this is.
Oh, wait a minute. What are you trying to pull? Put the gun down.
No.
Put the gun down.
Yes, it's really okay, Padre. You came in here and you thought I'd take advantage of you, sweetie. And, well, you came to her rescue. And I admire you for that. I just cannot tell you how much I admire you for it. I have hot pants for you.
From cocaine, I'm sure that it.
Now, shall we sit here, Ophelia?
Yes, let's start you into your little tunnel.
Oh, I don't need a bra, Evie.
Oh, you'd better not tuck you in, my dear. It's very, very chilly out here. There's been a sudden drop in the temperature, haven't you noticed? I say, haven't you noticed?
Yes.
Oh, hello, and what's your name?
The name is Oakley.
Oh, how do you do? I'm Mrs. George Bernard Shaw.
I say, oh dear, are you ill?
Oh, no.
Oh, dear, your hands are as cold as ice. We must be getting near an iceberg. I'm terribly worried, you know. I don't like ice. I slipped and fell last year. Right on my back porch.
Really?
Oh, are you English?
Quite.
That's how I knew you were English, because you said quite instead of yes, like any normal person would say. I just love to hear you talk. Why don't you talk some more? Why don't you go somewhere and talk?
Mrs. Shaw, do you mind? But I believe my fiancé needs a bit of a rest.
Your fiancé?
Yes.
You don't mean to tell me you're going to marry this dear child?
Oh, yes.
Well, I must kiss the bride. I certainly must kiss the bride.
Pardon me, ma'am, but you're in my dead chair.
Oh, that's all right.
You go sit in mine.
And that's my rock.
Hey, you sailor! What's going on here?
The sailor disguised himself as a woman and took possession of my deck chair.
We will find him, ma'am, and I promise you he will be severely dealt.
Well, I think we should clap him into a pair of chair eyes.
Oh, nonsense, Evie. He was only having a bit of fun. Oh,
but, oh dear, one must have discipline on shipboard. You know, aye, sir, women and children first, all that sort.
I think we should have a look around. I'm sure I can identify the crew. Right,
young lady.
Monsieur, your lunch?
I just got out of bed and had breakfast. Thanks.
Hey, what happened to sailor suit?
Well, the purser spotted it.
Doc, I've got to have some civilian clothes.
Okay, Chef, waiting for that order in the bar.
Oh, I just had a civilian coat.
Civilian coat?
Man overboard? Where? There! I'm coming! I'm coming!
I like your coat. You're wearing something like that face. I just had a beard.
A beard?
A beard.
Oh, a beard!
Excuse me, lady, can I talk to you for a minute?
Certainly. I noticed you on deck earlier talking about you. I recently organized a home for waiting girls.
Oh, try me with a name or two. I might know a couple.
We started with only 6 or 7, and now there are at least 70.
That's one business that keeps on moving.
Well, Doctor, I've enjoyed a little talk, but I've got to go and find my daughter now. I'll be seeing you.
I'm afraid so. Captain Weiss, I got to go buy a box of crockers.
But Mother, it's ridiculous chasing around the boat this way. He may not even be the man you think he is at all. The captain wants me to.
Pardon, is it not Mrs. Haircut
Harcourt? Mrs. Wadsworth T. Harcourt.
Oh, Charles. I was told to present myself to you from my dear cousin, the Duke of Hanover.
The Duke of Hanover? Yes, I met him in Paris last year.
Ah, yes. The French have been very kind to my poor exiled family since the Revolution.
Really?
dig it out after the French.
Oh, that is not all you dig after the
But now that I have found you, we must become, buddies? You and your lovely sister.
Oh, this is not my sister, my daughter.
Your daughter? Oh, it is not possible.
Oh, dear, I'd like you to meet this gentleman. This is my daughter, Miss Harcourt.
How do you do? I am Signor Arturo Antonio Marino Gracias. You can call me, Your Excellency.
I'm going to leave you two together now. I've got to go and find the captain. Au revoir!
Lovely woman, your grandmother.
Yes, mother is very nice.
It was so nice of her to leave us together. But all the time it was you. You with whom I wish to make speak. I see you have guessed my secret. I am not Signor Arturo Marino. No, I am George Bernardo Shaw. And I have the beard to prove it.
Cocktails?
I would adore to join you for cocktails.
Are you French or Spanish?
Neither. I'm a Chinchillian.
Here's Mark. See you later. I'll get you just a little while.
Dr. Moon, I've been looking for you. I'm afraid you're in for a bit of trouble. Are you up to the waiting? It's about those two contests.
You mean to tell me those two nice girls are comrades? Kiss, kiss!
No, the Chinese are.
Chinese comrades?
Oh, of course, of course. We don't permit gambling in the third class. I'm afraid you'll have to make them understand it, or we'll have to lock them up. I sent for them, and I'm going to turn them over to you.
Here they are, sir.
Hong Yong Pak Ping Pong Chow!
Ah, so?
You must have said something. Would you mind being a slow and get shocked in the place? Right.
You leave everything to you, Doctor.
Where's the bishop?
The bishop had to step out for a minute. Is there anything to do with you boys?
Beat boss, captain, foil game, took away Tom.
Oh, that's right, you've been gambling. Don't you know you shouldn't gamble? Not only is it sinful, but if you don't know how to keep off the bottom of the deck, you're going to lose all of your money.
We don't lose. We win $300.
You got $300? Kneel, Christians. There's a little game I'd like to show you. First, I've got $50 here. You put up your $300. That's just to make it easy. And then I'll roll a number. And if I roll the same number again before I roll 7, I win. If not, you win. Okay? Ha ha! Ha ha!
There's
something wrong here. And may the Lord watch over you. Make a better man.
Thank you. Wait
a minute, boys. What about my pair of dice?
Sir, that's me, pair of dice.
That's the spirit. Make the third class of pair
of dice. There's been a duck crap shooting around here. There's just been a duck crap shooting around here.
No. Trap shooting. We send play pigeons off the stern.
You shouldn't.
That's a job.
Yes, a first prize is $100 for me.
$100? Can I use my own gun?
I give you a
beauty.
Still I'm an unblemished rock. Blemished rock.
bathroom?
Mr. Whitney was lost.
No, my dear, I'm not lost. It's the bar that's lost. Let's step up, Mr. Gillicuddy.
Oh, Captain! Hey, Mr. Johnson.
Yes, we just woke in the sweet box. He's brushing up.
Then. Oh, I'm so glad I decided to take this boat.
No, no more autographs, please. Oh, Mr. Johnson. Mr. Johnson, I ain't talked to one of you before. Well, it's only two rooms and a bath, but you have nothing better to have to do. Well, if there's anything else, let me know. Well, there is one thing. I wonder if I could prevail on you to release Dr. Moon from the brig. Mr. Johnson, he's a dangerous character. He jumps around carrying a machine gun. Oh, that was mine. He took it from me. Did he try to form it?
He darn near made it, too.
Turn it loose, won't you, Captain, as a favor to me? I'd have to have a good talk with him first. He's a very strange sort of creature. Oh, you wouldn't say that if you saw him in action. I'll go down and have a talk with him out. If, as you say, he's on the side of war up there, then there can be no fears.
Well, how would you like to give us a little informal talk on jails I have known, Mr. Johnson? Why is it that they call you Snake Eyes, Mr. Johnson? Oh, and is it true that Japan does not dare attack America as long as you're alive?
Oh, cut it out. What are you trying to pull?
Aren't you proud of yourself, Mr. Johnson?
You can call me Snake Eyes.
This goes beyond living amusingly.
I haven't had so much fun since I was a kid.
Fine, you call it fun to masquerade around as one of the worst criminals ever lived?
It's not hurting anyone.
Hey, it's hurting my respect for you.
Well, how about your respect for these darn fools that are making a hero out of me?
I've never had any respect for them. But you, maybe. You can stop all this nonsense if you really want to.
All right. I'll make them lay off this hero worship. I won't have anything more to do with it.
Oh, Billy. Oh, do you really mean that?
I promise.
Oh, Mr. Johnson, we're waiting for you.
You girls go ahead without me.
We can't.
But I was
you
just...
have the crown, Miss Cuthbert.
I was just telling Miss Cuthbert.
Remember, you said you were the crown, Miss Cuthbert.
A castle does not have an exotic
name, dear. Oh,
Evelyn. Oh, dear. Have you seen the moon?
No, I haven't.
Oh, well, you should take a look at it. It's most inspiring.
Well, I see you finally found your sea legs. Hey, was that a crack at my pins?
Oh, no, I'm sure she meant no offense, dear.
Boy, you're great stuff on deck. I bet you'd be hell in a taxi cab.
You know, tonight for the first time, I understand my people speak so highly of the moonlight.
You know, Evie, when we get to England and have to separate, I'm afraid I'll be carrying the old torch.
Carrying the old torch? Oh, so you've been hearing all that nonsense about the London fog.
No, Evie. That means I'll be miserable without you.
Does it really? Carrying the old torch. Well, how picturesque.
You know, Evie, if things had worked out, would you like to get together?
Get together? Oh, you mean become engaged, married?
That could do for a beginning.
I must admit this does come as something of a shock. I never considered you the one man type.
Neither had I, until now.
At least 20 men a year proposed to you. Bankers, politicians, big movie stars.
But not one of them stirs my pulse. I like a man with class and dignity and savoir. It's getting late and while I wait, my poor heart aches on. Why keep the brain on? Let's misbehave. I feel quite sure. Oh, Padamore.
Wait a minute, brothers and sisters.
Well, I'm just cursed with sex appeal. That's been my problem.
She's not confessing. She's advertising. Come on, get busy. Give us a real confession.
Come on, you can tell me. I know what sin is. I've been a sinner.
There was a time when I led a poor girl astray.
Now that's life. Do we hear from that lady, man? Two, do I hear three?
I'll make it three.
So, the man with the blood short arm.
May I say a word?
Sure.
Speak up, brother.
Well, I've never played this game before, but I am rather enjoying it, and I like to add my bit. I'm afraid I can't compete with these gentlemen in point of numbers, but I made in a touch of color. When I was visiting China Hill some time ago, there was this little Chinese girl named Plum Blossom, of whom I became very fond. Eventually, we had an unpremeditated romp in rice, and I enjoyed it very much. Thank you.
I was worried about you, brother, but I feel much better now.
Sir Eamon, would you repeat what you just said?
Oh, well, certainly, I was
Mr. Johnson, it's your turn now after all this is all being done for you.
Oh, yes, do go ahead, Mr. Johnson. We all know there have been a great many women in your life.
Go ahead, brother, you can talk these guys.
Yes, brother, get right with yourself.
Speak up, Mr. Johnson, you're among friends.
Sure. Yes, Mr. Johnson, they want a confession. Why don't you give them a real one? This is your big chance to tell us all the truth. Please?
All right, if it's a confession you want, I'll give you a confession. But first of all, I want to tell you something. I haven't heard anyone confess that he's ashamed to know public enemy number one. You're proud to know me, proud to be on the same boat with me. You fight to shake my hand. And why? Because I'm a celebrity. What kind of a celebrity? The biggest murderer in the world. Well, the joke's on you. And you. I'm not the biggest murderer in the world. I'm not Snake Eyes Johnson. William C. Crocker, a broken down broker.
Mercer, throw this imposter in the brig.
Oh, no, Captain Billy.
You're under arrest.
For what?
For stealing a first class ticket and passport.
Now, wait a minute, Boyles. If you girls want a real public enemy to ride wise, I am to be Moonface Martin, public enemy number 13.
Then you're going to the break with him.
Hey, what? What's going on? Stop going on here, Bonnie!
Let that be a lesson to you sinners. Search your hearts. Sign out with Satan and tune in with heaven. Where will you stand on the day of glory? Do you hear that playing?
Yes, we hear that playing.
Do you know who's playing?
No, who's that playing?
Why, it's Gabriel playing. Gabriel playing. Will you be ready to go when I blow my horn?
Once more, so one's dead.
Now look here. All right, I'll look at it for you. Now don't tell me where it is.
I wonder what time it is.
I've got 1:30.
1:30 what?
I don't know. I lost a little baby. A little baby.
It's Friday. We're in port.
We are.
While you're up there, take a good look at England. That's all you're going to see of it.
So that's what there is. Looks like a dull day in the office.
5 days in this terrible dump. It's a wonder I haven't gone out of my mind.
Oh, this isn't fair. You've been in jail in Cicero. I'll be the new jail, it'll be the old one.
Cut with the travel actors, will you, Doc?
You know, I've been in a lot of tough loose cats. But down in Fayetteville, Arkansas, they got just about as nice a jail as you ever want to see.
Doc, please.
Just trying to put your mind on something pleasant. I knew you was thinking about her.
That's all I think about. Day and night, I even dream about her.
Oh,
case and this, and not even a note from her. I know something's happened to her. They locked her in her cabin or she's sick or something.
You'll hear from her. She's all right.
She's probably off the boat by now. They'll marry her to that Englishman while they're sending me back to America, and I'll probably never see her again.
Sure you will. They can't give you more than 10 years.
Thanks. You're a big help.
I'm upset myself. I'm just trying to cheer you up. You know, I did want to work up from number 15 before they got to the hot squad. You know, the boys told me the chair at Juliet's a little bit wider than the wooden sink, so we get a little bit heavier here.
You're breaking my heart.
Maybe we're looking too much on the dark side, boy. Let's try to find the silver lining. Remember, it's always darkest before it turns on the lights. There's an old Australian blues song that Melvin used to sing. A song that always cheered me when I was blue. Even Melvin sang his blues song, so I know it's so hard to sing. So be quiet whilst I render it to you. When your instinct tells you that your sense is approaching you faster and faster, then be like a bluebird and sing sweet, sweet, la 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 la. When you know your care for the children, don't allow your face to grow pale, but be like a bluebird and sing tweet, tweet, run up. Like the bluebird who never gets what singing can do. And though by other birdies in the burrows he's using and his embers are perfectly lousy. He sings on and on until his true lovers are thrilled.
Hey, Mom! Oh,
with you. How are they treating you?
Oh, it's swell here. It's just that they won't let me up to see you.
What are they going to do with you?
They're sending me back to America. I haven't a ticket or a passport, but I'll be on the first boat back to England.
Oh, no, Billy, you mustn't come back to England.
Oh, you can't marry England. You're in love with me.
That's what I've come to explain. Mother's insisting that we get married right away, and then she's talked to Captain and Mary and he's right here on shipboard before we even reach London.
What am I supposed to say? Thanks, it's been swell. See you around?
Oh, I don't know, Billy.
It's crazy, skyline is right in my eye. Curiosity.
Even with this song is wild out.
Yes.
Oh,
La-dee-da-do-do, so you jump in.
I'm afraid under the circumstances, I don't see how I can marry Miss Harcourt.
Nonsense, Evelyn. All these people want is money.
Money, money, money.
Listen here, you chaps. I'll give you £1,000 to clear out.
£1,000
That's money. $5,000.
Well, take it!
Do not insult us with offer of filthy money.
I'll make it $2,000.
Rich man cannot buy Chinese honor.
I'll make it $5,000.
Chinese honor sold!
No, you have to pay them. No amount of money can settle this great wrong. You, sir.
English ladies speak to me?
Yes. You are a relative of Little Jumbo? Then the only way to settle this great debt of honor, Evelyn, is for you to offer him me.
Marvelous idea.
Oh, no.
Offer accepted. Chinese on the safe.
What about 5,000?
Oh, you're getting quite a girl.
But why not English gentlemen right wrong done to Bumma? Join the club, kiddo.
Join the club, kiddo. Oh, confound it, Miss Blombossom. Rita, will you marry me?
I thought you never asked, sweetie.
Tell the captain for me he runs a very loose ship. Boss, Billy, what are you doing here?
How is everything? How was your trip?
Oh, it was terrible. I lost my glasses. I've been blind for 5 days.
So I've heard.
What about the amalgamation?
Oh, you didn't want to have anything to do with that. As a matter of fact, I just flew over here to tell you that I landed 2 new accounts. The Oakley interests and the Harcourt account. As a matter of fact, this is Mrs. Harcourt. Elisha J. Whitney. You know Wall Street?
Did you say Wall Street, Mr. Whitney?
Madam, may I tempt you with a little drink?
Sir, liquor has never touched my lips.
You know a shortcut?
Now that there are going to be 2 weddings, may I offer you the courtesy of the ship I'm referring to for your honeymoon? You will join Dr. Moffat and fortunately turn over to the authorities.
Captain, we've received a radiogram from Washington.
Read it yourself. Moonface Mark, not wanted. Entirely harmless, wouldn't hurt a flea.
Why have you been so insulted in my life? You're
American! You know, shall we practice misbehaving?
You bet your sweet Ascot.
Ascot Fuchsia. Holding solito.
If that means what I think it does, the answer is yes.
Where did you say you were staying in London, Mr. Whitney?
Dear lady, wherever you are.
Well, doctor.
Can you stay away from me? Rosh, you